Hello friends, and in this video I'll be helping you with history of embedded system. So what was the go through phase of embedded system, or we can say the initialization of embedded system till now? What embedded system actually are, you can get embedded system almost everywhere nowadays. So what was the go through phase of embedded system? I'll be talking about that. So let's start. So you cannot figure out any exact we can say start of embedded system that year. This was actually the first embedded system design, but we can say that one of the very first, we can say first recognizable modern embedded system was Apollo Guidance Computer at MIT. So this was one among the first modern embedded system that were recognizable. It was around the year 1960. After that, we know that nowadays embedded system are designed in mass product, but when was the first embedded system designed in mass production? Was around 1961. Early mass production embedded system was the Autonomic D-17 guidance computer for Minuteman missile. So Minuteman missiles were designed in the year 1961. They were among the large scale production, we can say, or mass production of embedded system. Nowadays embedded system are designed in mass production, but the start of mass production was from the year 1961. After this, Minuteman II missile came in the year 1966. That was the first, we can say, computer to have integrated circuit, or we can say the high volume of integrated circuit were embedded in that. So it was actually the, we can say, first embedded system that was that can properly be called as embedded system. So from here, embedded systems look out, or we can say the face of embedded system changed. After this, we can say that since the year 1960, price of embedded system have came down increasingly. Production it's but obvious, because in the year 1960, when embedded system was first introduced, there were only missiles and few equipments, computers. That computer's cost was very high. Though they were specialized, but their cost and resources were too costly to be afforded by us common person. But slowly the cost have been decreased, and till date it has been decreased too much. Thus increasing production as well as processing power also increased, because more researches was done and functionality also increased with it. An early stage microprocessor, for example Intel 404, had just calculator. So Intel 404 had just calculator and some small kind of functions other than calculator it could provide you, but it required many support chips as well as external memory also was required. So we can say at early start of embedded system, there were very less functionality provided, but there were a lot of use of resources. So it has very less efficiency at starting, but slowly it became good. In 1978, National Engineering Manufacturer Association released a standard which released that any company want to make embedded system has to follow those standard. This resulted in, we can say, the proper manufacture of embedded system. As cost of microprocessor fell, it increased dramatically, replacing analog. So with a decrease in the cost of embedded, we can say microprocessor or embedded system, it started replacing analog, right? Microcontroller find application where general purpose computer would be costly, right? Like for example, if you want to hear just music, you just want to hear music, you will take a iPod to hear music rather than using a computer, buying a Mac laptop and then playing a song on that, right? So microcontroller provides you is, like for example, you want to click a picture, just that much, you don't want a computer. So why will you buy a computer rather than buying just a little camera that will be very less costly as compared to a laptop? So all those we can say that embedded system are complex than traditional, or we can say analog system. They are more complex to design, but the complexity is just concerned with we can say a microcontroller only. And nowadays you can see that microcontroller are available in market. You can buy it and you can just embed it in your system which you want to, right? So nowadays embedded system designing is very easy. You can buy the embedded system, sorry, we can say microcontroller from a shop and embed it in your system to make it functional, right? So this makes embedded system more easy and more faster and more better day by day. So this was all about the history of embedded system. If you like the video, do hit the like button and do consider subscribing, and thanks for watching.